Amen. We want to have a short exhortation. And this man of God we want to call upon is a very mighty man of God. Hallelujah. He ministered in our church this morning. There's one thing I remember him for saying. He said, in Ghana we have taken so much of people's money in our pocket that our own money is not coming. Hallelujah. And I think I love that statement. Amen. He's an international man. In fact, nations are in this house. Amen. Spain is here. Australia is here. America is here. Denmark is also here. Hallelujah. He's coming all the way from Denmark. Specifically, he's in the Apostolic Church. He travels to minister in various nations. God is using him very mightily. Amen. He came with his family, his wife, Mrs. Dina. Can you give us a wave? Mrs. Dina. Dina and the sister Tabitha. And I think, yeah, can you give us a wave? Oh, can we clap our hands together for them? The distance alone is not easy. Hallelujah. Amen. And with a standing ovation and with a mighty clap offering, giving honor to whom honor is due, shall we welcome to the pulpit Pastor Kobby. Hallelujah. Through the Lord Almighty clap offering.
Very short. In John chapter 20 verse 21, you can have your seat, please. Are you here with me? In John chapter 20 verse 21, he says, Jesus speaking. So then Jesus said unto them again, say again. When Jesus repeats himself, that means that you have to think through it again. Jesus is not a stammerer. So when he says again, then you have to pay attention to it. He said, Jesus said to them again, peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, even so I'm sending you. As the Father has sent me, so I'm sending you. So you seated here, you are a sent vessel. What are you sent to do? You are sent to propagate the gospel. And when I talk about propagating the gospel, it's not a matter of holding or standing before a pulpit. Ministers of God, or the five-fold ministry, we use the pulpit as a medium to communicate the life of God. But when you are not called into the ministry, the traditional way of preaching the gospel, when you are not called into it, you have a calling. When Jesus said that, go into the world and preach the gospel, in Matthew chapter 28, he used the word nations. He says, go preach the word unto all nations. The word nation there is called ethnos in the Greek. And ethnos means that not necessarily traveling to the world, but your own world. At your workplace, that is your world. In your family, that is your world. In your academics, that is your world. Then it says that preach the gospel in your own world. So you are called by God to minister the gospel in your world. Where is your world? Are you lighting up the world you are in, or you are darkening the world you are in? Bible says that we are the light of the world, and therefore we have to shine for people to follow us. When you arrive at your workplace, people have to see light, because you are called by God. That is your world. Your world is your place of influence. Your world is a place that you have immediate attachment. So he said, go into all the world and preach the gospel. So you don't need to have the title of a pastor to start preaching the gospel, because you have your own talent to use to preach the gospel. Your profession is a medium for preaching the gospel. The pastor's medium of preaching the gospel might be the pulpit. Your own is your profession. You use your profession as a medium to reach people with the gospel. That is the call of the Lord. So I came to just give you a challenging message that where you are working, you can affect them with the gospel. You don't need the title of a pastor to affect them. If you start to leave the gospel, corruption will cease at your workplace. I said at a church that too much corruption is in the country, and I asked, why are the Christians? the Christians are also involved. But the Bible says that we are the light of the world. How is your light shining where you are? God told Moses, what do you have in your hands? And he said, I have a rope. He said, use that rope. Your medium of reaching out to people might be your talent. How are you using it? Can I hear an amen?